Namaste, one and all. Myself, Dr. Sujitra from ABP family. So here what I present before you is a very humbly an observation I have made of this patient. I am not the treating physician. So my topic for the day is Ayurvedic management of chronic rheumatoid arthritis with severe deformities, a case study. So introducing the patient, she is a 62-year-old female. She is a non-resident Indian based in the US. So she was clinically diagnosed by an allopath to have RA at the age of 12. So almost 50 years, she is now 62, 50 years she has been living with the disease. So the pain used to be, and all her conditions of stiffness used to be on and off. So she used to do her routine work on painkillers and DMRs. This went on until the blizzard struck in December 2010 in New York, when she became completely immovable and not able to get up from her wheelchair. So she came back to India in 2011, and it was only in 2012 that she started the Ayurvedic medication. So first she comes for OP medications, and after a brief OP prescription, she later came for admission 35 days, and then she is still on follow-up medication. The baseline findings that we had regarding the joints, almost all the joints were severely tender, and in the patient's words, the knees were the most affected, especially the right knee was very stiff, and it was giving her the greatest problem. And because she was trying to adjust to her painful body condition, she was almost bent like a bow. And she was completely wheelchair bound, as I had mentioned earlier. Even on the slightest movement, she used to literally scream with pain. She had such excruciating pain. She had a stasis ulcer on her left ankle that was about 1 to 1.5 centimeters wide. The same condition she had 10 years back in US. Then she was treated with bandaging and dressing, got complete relief. But when the same condition recurred after 10 years and she tried the same treatment, they found that there was no change at all. It was severely oozing with a foul smell. And she says in the patient's words, after the blizzard and she became wheelchair bound, she lost nearly 19 kgs. So the blood parameters we measured at baseline were RA factor was 640, the CRP was 5.24, ESR is 124, HB was 10. The joint counts, we had 27 painful joints, swollen joints were 14, and the DAS score was 5.19. So when we say count joint counts, painful joints, almost all the hip was not very painful when compared to the others, but almost all the other joints were painful, and swollen joints were 14. So here we have the x-rays that the patient had submitted to us. You can see the x-ray of both the knees completely fused together, and one x-ray of the hand where we can see the Swan neck deformity. So when she came to our OPD for prescription, I'm not going into the details of medication, but our target was to bring about the Ama Pachana, to bring about the Rakta Pitta Hara, at the same time to normalize the clogged Vayu present in the joints. So there were 4 prescriptions given. As we practically do, it is normally given for 1 month, until unless the patient has some difficulty or any aggravation of the symptoms, mild changes are made in the prescription. And after 4 OP prescriptions, she came to us for IP treatment. So we did 7 days of oil massage, followed by 14 days of intensive Dara and Pilchil treatment, 5 days of Kadikiri that is done with whey water, 7 days of Navaratepa, it is a massage that is done with the Shashtika rice, 7 days of Kshiravasti, and then we had 7 days of Matravasti with Madhyashtyadi Tailam. Although she was undergoing all these treatments locally, because the knee was giving her the worst nightmare, we were doing Kshiradhara and Lepam with Jadamayadi Churna. So after her IP treatment was over, we again gave her the follow-up prescription that included certain medications again to normalize the Vayu, at the same time to reduce the pain. We had given her Karaskara Dhrutam for external application. So some changes we observed were, the very first change that we observed in the patient was, amazingly, the oozing and the foul smell from the ulcer started to come down. So we were expecting some change in the pain, but it was the ulcer that started responding first. And after that, we saw that there were changes both clinically in the blood parameters, as I will show you now, as well as symptomatically. The patient was complaining the degree of pain reducing, and she was able to do her work better than earlier. And during the IP treatment, one important thing that we noticed was her BP level was shooting up. It almost came to 200. But we didn't have to take any allopathic medication. We managed it with Ayurvedic medications. So these are the blood parameters. So over a period from March 2012, right from the baseline finding until November, after her IP treatment, we have recorded her blood parameters. So you can see the RA factor that was 640, it has almost become 64, 10 times less. The CRP that was 5.24, over a period of time, it has become 1.2. ESR that was 124 has come to 76 last measure. And finally, HB that was 10, of course, mild variation, it has come a little low. The DAS scores were as follows. So again, that was from baseline to the end point. We found that the score that was 5.19 has come down to 2.45. So when the difference is actually said to be greater than 1.2, it is considered to be a good sign, a good response to the disease. So my discussion for today is what we see from the patient. The patient is very comfortable with minimal pain and she is able to do almost all her routine activities. And to be frank, the right knee is still problematic because you have seen the x-rays, it is completely fused, that condition cannot be reversed, but she is able to tolerate and do her work. And recently, as of now, after November, she has not done any blood test. Maybe when she comes for a follow-up, we will ask her to do it again. And now the patient is on very minimal medication. So something that I would like to tell here is that the treatment for Vadarakta was clearly done, only the treatment for Vadarakta. But we found that it also improved her ulcer and ulcer completely cured. So this simple logic that because Vadarakta also targets Rakta, the clogged blood, the circulation is improved and then the ulcer has healed. So maybe this treatment can be tried for varicosity and even for vascular disorders. And after the inpatient treatment, we, as I already told, there was a complete dramatic change in the lab test and also in the clinical symptoms. And after the inpatient treatment, the patient also showed that her knee was a little better. The pain that she experienced earlier, it was a little less when compared after the treatment. The Karaskaradhritam, we discontinued it. Of course, there were some toxicity issues. So after some period of applying Karaskaradhritam, we stopped it. So my conclusion for today after my slide presentation is, actually our acharyas mentioned that Vadarakta with the deformities and the last stage has to be tyaje. It has to, is unmanageable, but I think this case is a very good example to say that even RA with severe deformities, with Ayurveda, we can definitely improve the quality of life within a very short period of time. So here you can see it was 7 months of Ayurvedic medication versus a 50-year-old disease, and it is definitely essential that further studies are warranted to explore the scope of Ayurveda so that we can improve the quality of life in such patients like her who are suffering with severe deformities. So last but not the least, with the patient's consent, I had taken a small audio recording so you could hear what she has to tell us.
You haven't done it, like?
I haven't done it.
So now after the, you heard in live what she had to say. So after she has finished all her treatments, when I call up to find out how she's doing, she tells me, I don't need so many medications from you. I'm taking only two, whichever she is comfortable with. And she says she will do a test maybe after 2 or 3 months. So I think it is, we can definitely improve the quality of life even in severe cases of rheumatoid arthritis that has got severe deformities. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you. No virejana was done. Actually, when I asked the same question, so the treating physician told that because she was completely dhatukshaya stage, so we will instead go only for shiravasthi and virejana.
Even though dhatukshaya is there, definitely some mudu virejana is having some spot. Because how the sewer work in the snaiva, say the samshoga in the sewer, that is a place there. Moreover, snaiva is also to be done in a very sadhya snaiva like Sevana Upadhyaya Snaiva, Snaiva, Yudhivira, some adding some Saita word or something. So the two of the word that's there for that. And we don't know the Mitra Dosa. So you know, very deep seated action is there for this Snaiva. So Rastavana is also very good. So Rastavana is not able to put up. Definitely we can go for some materials the Shirabhaka organize. These are meant for, not for improving the condition at all, but for getting some sustained effect, some continuing effect. These are some failure. These are some wonderful things. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.